Welcome to this presentation. My name is Andrew Mallett and we're going to take a look at using SUSE Linux Enterprise Server 11 and setting up NIC bonding. It's easiest to set this up through YUSD. So if I open up YUSD and have a look at my networking settings, you can see that I've got two network cards that are currently unconfigured. We minimize this and then take a look at our terminal. I'm in etc sysconfig network, and if we look at an ls, we can see that I don't have a configuration for my eth0 or eth1 network cards. And again, if I look at the output, let's make the font just a wee bit bigger, IP address show, you can see that neither ETH1 or ETH0 have an IP address. So they've got their IP version 6 addresses, which they would always have based around their MAC address, but they don't have an IP version 4 address. As I say, it is easiest to set this up in the first instance using YUSD, but once we've got YUSD set up, we can then use the templates that YUSD would create to recreate this setting on more or less any machine. So we'll have a look at doing it both ways. So we'll go through and look at how we configure it first of all in YUSD. Once we've got our configuration files for bond0, our bonding interface, it'd be very easy to recreate this on any machine. So if I add in then a new network card, and then on the device type, we're going to choose then from the list available, and you can see that we've got bond. It's going to be my first bond device, so I'm going to set it up as bond0. I don't need any ETH tool options for this. As we follow the wizard through, I'm going to leave it on DHCP. It should pick up an address through DHCP. I don't need any other options. But we then go through to my bonding slaves, and then we're going to include ETH0 and ETH1. We can set bonding options down here. The default, as you can see then, is active backup. That means one of the interfaces is going to be used, the other one then will not be used, and it's for failover. I'm going to leave it on failover at the moment. If I look at the other options, common one that's often used is load balancing with round robin. So if we've got two devices such as I've got here, we would first use ETH0, the next request would come in would be using ETH1, the next request would be using ETH0, and so on. So it allows me to do a very simple load balancing. And really we've got other complexities that we can add in. And with this, really, I can't explain all of them in a short video, but just take a look at some of the documentation. So we're going to use then active backup for a failover situation. We can then move on to next and then OK. So it's creating the configuration file now, so it will create the IFCFG for bond0. It will start that network interface, and obviously we should now have a network address. So if I clear the screen with Control L, and then we'll go through and have a look. So if I use my listing again, we can see now that I've got a configuration file for bond0. If I look at my IP address show, we can now see we still do not have any IP address for ETH0, ETH1, but one bond0 has got an IP address of 192.168.153.128. And we should be able to access it from my host machine. So if I go through, try and ping the machine, then of course we're getting a response. If we minimize this, if I kill off one of my network adapters, so I'm just going out to my VMware system tray and I'm disconnecting one of my network cards. So it's hard for you to see, but I have disconnected one of the cards. Then go back, have a look, and we're still able to ping. Of course, if I didn't reconnect this network card and then disconnected the other network card, then I would have no response at all. So again, we'll minimize this. We'll drop back. I'm going to enable my network card. We can just see a warning about the MAC address coming up. I'm going to disable the other network card. And we'll then drop back and try pinging again, and we're still getting a response. So here we're getting, if you like, a little bit of failover protection. If a network card fails, presumably they wouldn't be plugged into the same switch or the same hub, then we can still get a response. If we look at our configuration file, so vi ifcfg -bond0, we can see then the options. This is where I say it's very easy for me to configure this then as a template and use this on virtually any machine. Copy this configuration file across, then just make sure that I've got kernel devices called eth0 and eth1. They would have no configuration, so there is only a configuration for bond0. There is no configuration for eth0 or eth1. And of course, I could use it with static IP addresses in the same way as I would within a normal network configuration. So hopefully this gives you a simple idea of how we can set up bonding or teaming of our network cards. We've demonstrated here using failover protection for our network cards, but we could equally use it with the balance RR, our round robin, for load balancing. Thank you, and I look forward to seeing you again soon.